Hey everyone, welcome to S-Tech. My name is Senthil. In this video, I'm going to set up my S22 Ultra for the first time with Android Auto in my car. So let's just get and see how it's going to work for the first time while setting up the Android Auto in S22 Ultra. Now, with my old phone, since I have been using it for many years, all I have to do is just take the cable that is already connected to the port and just plug it in like that. And then once it does, it pops up with the Android Auto app, and then you can see in the car that already it's loading it. And it's already loaded the and it's already loaded the Android Auto here. Now all I'm going to do right now is, let me just go back. So you can get to the apps, you can see maps comes on, map comes out, the audio plays automatically from where I left off, and everything works with my old device, which is a Pixel 3 XL. Now I'm going to unplug this and just going to plug in into S22 Ultra for the first time setting up the Android Auto. So let's just see how it works. So I'm just going to plug my USB cable here. As soon as I do it, it just does charge, but you can see here on the car display, it says that do you want to enable the Android Auto from this device, whether you want to do it just once or always enable. Generally, I do it just enable once with the rental cars, but with this, my personal car, I'm going to do always enable. And in the mobile, it already says Android Auto has disconnected. So when it says restart Android Auto by reconnecting your phone USB cable again, but let's just see what happens. I'm going to unlock the phone. Okay, the car is still showing loading, so I'm just going to maybe unplug one more time and I'm going to plug it again. Yeah, it's again gives me the warning. Okay, I'm going to plug again. Okay, now this time, because maybe I did not unlock the phone last time, it did not give me this welcome to Android Auto screen. So this is the first time I'm doing it, so you have to set up this in the mobile, and you can see clearly the message which says that when safe, please check the smartphone. So you have to do all these things in the parking mode while setting up for the first time. Okay, so I'm going to do next. Okay. To continue, select Android Auto on the car screen. So that's all. So you can see here, in my case, it's the Pixel 3 XL is already been connected. So it says that would you like to disconnect and connect the new device? I'll say yes. Yeah, and then you can see here Bluetooth connected to S22 Ultra already, and you can see would you like to turn on Honda Link Assist? I'll say on. That there you go. So it says welcome. So basically, I'll say okay, And with this Android Auto, you can use maps, phone calls, Spotify or YouTube music, and then you can also get messages which can be read out to you. So I'm just going to say okay. There you go. So we are back into the app screen of Android Auto in the mobile or in the car. And then I'm just going to the maps, and then you can see here we can just look at the maps or go to the any address here we want, and then we can touch the screen and ask Google Assistant. So let's just try that, because for the first time when we try it, it's also going to ask us to allow the setup. So let's just finish that one as well. So let's just do okay. Show me the nearby Target stores.
Here's what I found for show me the nearby Target stores.
Okay, it says no results, so I will just cancel this, and then I will once again do that. What's the weather right now?
Right now in Temecula, it's 13 degrees with fog. Today, it'll be cloudy with a forecasted high of 18 and a low of 11.
So there you go. It's tells us the weather. Okay. Now, when the Android Auto is connected, you can also still use the phone, so the passenger can still use the phone while driving. So you can see here, I'm going in, and we can access the mobile without any issues, but it is still not recommended to use the mobile while driving. But always, as always, the passenger can do it. Mostly the calls, you can directly accept the calls in the screen itself, and also search any location that you need to go to directly over. I'm going to now turn off my car, unplug the Android Auto, turn off the car, and then turn on again, and then plug it in to see if I need to do anything again with the setup, right? So I'll just go to turn off. Okay, so now I will turn on my car. Okay, at this point, you can just plug it in. That way it will right away comes up with Android Auto. So you can see here I plugged it in, and right away it started loading. Now by the time I generally back up my car and start going, this screen loads up already. But let's just see this time how long does it take. Yeah, there you go. So it's already loaded. And then you can see here, it's asking this time, allow access and all. So with the messages, so I'm just going to say allow, and then lock this phone and put it away, and then get going with the car. Right? Android Auto is working perfectly, plugging and unplugging multiple times. It just right away comes up. Right, I'll do it one more time for the third time here, and you can see here right away it loads up without any issues. So that's all for this video today. Thanks for watching again. Like and subscribe for more videos like this.